foretold the coming of Messiah centuries before Jesus was born. He proclaimed that those announcing his arrival would also declare the peace that Messiah would bring. Isaiah wrote, "How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of the herald, who proclaims peace, who brings news of good things, who proclaims salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. The angel announced it to the shepherds, and we have been singing it ever since."
Imagine that first Christmas night and the angelic announcement that peace and goodwill had come to earth. The shepherds must have been amazed and relieved that to their world, full of chaos, peace had finally come. But did they believe it? More importantly, do we believe it now? After all, when we look around the world today, peace and goodwill don't seem to be in ample supply. Peace on earth, goodwill to men. Is this what Jesus brought to us?
Peace on earth, good. Yes, that is what Jesus brought to us. In the middle of a world draped in chaos and filled with hate, we live by faith with a peace that surpasses all human understanding. But God's peace is not only intended for us. It makes it available for all. And that's why we tell the world about Jesus and sing of the life and joy that only He can bring.
Still the world is waiting, longing for the day when peace on earth, goodwill to men, is more than words we say.
The peace that Isaiah foretold and the angels announced is still unknown by so many. The world was waiting for it then, and the world is waiting for it now. But listen to Isaiah again. For a child will be born for us, a son will be given to us, and the government will be upon his shoulders. He will be named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. Centuries before Jesus was born, the prophet also declared, "Who has believed what we have heard? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed?" He grew up before him as a young plant and like a root out of dry ground. He didn't have an impressive form or majesty that we should look at him, no appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by man, but man of suffering what sickness was. But he was pierced because of our rebellion, crushed because of our iniquities, punished for our peace was on him. And we are healed by his stripes. We all went astray like sheep. We all have turned to his own way. And the Lord has punished him for the iniquity of us all. Jesus did come as a baby, not as the earthly king they all expected. He came as a lamb to be slain. He gave his life. But he rose again and waits at the Father's right hand for the time of his return. The last chapter hasn't been written. The one who was promised to come the first time has promised to come again.
His peace, real peace, will come with him. And this same Jesus will reign forevermore.
Baby boy in a manger, the one the prophets foretold, our long-awaited Redeemer, wrapped up in swaddling clothes.
The one that John called the Lamb of God.
stood there in silence as they condemned him to die. Led like a lamb to the slaughter, he freely laid down his life.
He cried, "It is finished," as he took that last breath.
Was buried, but then arose from the grave, forever conquering death.
This same Jesus is coming again. The trumpet will sound, the Lord will descend. This same Jesus will reign evermore as King of kings and Lord of lords.
And His kingdom will be a kingdom of peace. He's turned the wheel to
them. This same Jesus is coming back again.
This same Jesus is coming again. The trumpet will sound, the Lord will descend. This same Jesus will reign evermore as King of kings and Lord of lords.
His kingdom will be a kingdom of peace, peace and goodwill to men.
This same Jesus is coming back.
Is coming back.
This same Jesus is coming back.
Is coming back.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.